Good afternoon, everyone, and welcome to Redbird Replay. This is Scott Kirker along with Joel Nealon once again. Joe, glad you made it back again for this third, fourth place game. This is a big game for Metamora.
Yeah, thanks for having me. And, you know, it's a big game. North Lawndale, third year in a row we're playing them here, so excited to see what happens.
You know, last year, North Lawndale was the school that we played. I believe they held the ball for all but, like, what, 4 seconds of the second quarter. There were no points scored in the second quarter by either team?
It was over 7 minutes, and we just stood there and watched them, and I think there was no points, and it kind of messed up everybody's flow, but it was close to the end, and that's what we wanted to do. So I'm excited to see what Coach has in mind tonight for him.
Yeah, this was kind of a tough loss the other night, lost by 3 on a buzzer beater. That was the fourth time in 4 years that we've been coming to the State Farm Tournament that we've lost on a buzzer beater.
Yeah, it's crazy luck, but, you know, it's just how it is over Metamora.
So we've been in a lot of games and just, you know, unlucky, whatever you want to call it, but we've just never been able, well, I shouldn't say never, we just we've been a little bit snake bit.
Right, yeah, it hurts, but, you know, yeah, it's not really under control when they make lucky shots at the end.
And I do like the way Metamora is starting to play, and we've talked about this before. You know, this really sets us up well for the conference play. You know, when we come back after the break, next Saturday we play Manual, and then it's, you know, we get pretty heavy into the conference schedule.
Right. You know, the emergence of Zach Schroeder, you know, as a sophomore, a lot of the guys are just starting to step up, and it's nice to see him gel together. It's early in the year.
You know, I think it's really important, too, that, you know, you don't have to depend completely on Landon Ivins to be the guy that brings the ball up. Give him a break,
right.
Send him to the wing, and let Ethan Kaiser, you know, bring the ball up. It doesn't mean that Landon isn't the point guard. It's just that he isn't the guy that doesn't always have to bring the ball up. And I think that's been a big key for Metamora.
Right, that's been huge. You know, Ethan being 6'6", it's a matchup nightmare trying to guard him, you know, whether it's inside or in the full court. So it's really been nice having that.
And you sit here and you watch him shoot some of these shots down in the corner, and, you know, he's hitting nothing but net.
Yeah, it was good.
That's so, for sure. You know, we don't have the Danny Greaves pregame talk. He's been a little bit superstitious about coming up. So,
yeah.
And that's fine. Most coaches are superstitious to a degree. And the other thing, too, is as we get ready for I'm not sure if they'll play the national anthem before this game or not, but I know they're having starting lineups. The elevated play of Ryan Begol, too, has been big for Metamora.
Yeah, they needed him off the bench, especially last game. They still lost, but he was big in the fourth quarter.
I think it's just going to be the starting lineups.
Representing the Middle Line Conference and appearing in the home team. massive Artesian ready to go. The head coach of the Redbirds is Danny Creek, assisted by Justin Gamble, Mike Brockhouse, Patrick Vaughn, Jake Springer, and Roger Mitchell. And now the starting lineup for the Metamora Redbird. Starting at guard, six-foot senior number four, Wendy Eisen. And guard, six-foot sophomore number 11, Nate Schroeder. And forward, a 6'6 freshman number 21, Ethan Eiser. And forward, a 6'6 senior 23, Kate Mason. And forward, a 6'6 senior number 32, Caleb Eiser.
Well, Joe, it's going to be a battle of who can control the tempo the most, because North Lawndale is going to want to run. Metamora is going to want to slow it down a little bit.
Right. You know, whoever controls the pace of the ball is going to win the game, so we'll see what happens.
Metamora. Kaiser wins the tip.
Yeah, he does. I'm impressed.
Who?
Down goes Fraser. Looks like they're switching everything, so it's not really a chance to get on the ball screen.
Well, you can see that one coming from.
Yeah. Big start for North Lawndale. Deep three from Mason.
Good. 3-2 Redbirds. And they hit a three, and that's 5-3.
That's what they do. They, you know, those deep threes from the wings is what they shoot.
Oh, nice, nice, nice finger roll by Landon Ivins. 5-5, 6-11 to go, first quarter. Oh, man. Schroeder got another hand on the ball.
Such long arms.
Tied up at 5. Here in the early going. And that rolls in. 7-5, Lawndale.
Good look from Mason.
Ooh. Ooh, just missed.
Quick shot.
Nice rebound by Ivins. Makes it 9-5, North Lawndale. Kind of nudged Ethan Kaiser out of bounds.
Yeah.
Need a bucket here, just under five to go.
Miss.
It's a nice drive. We got to convert in those though, because we're not going to get a lot of looks.
Right. But if we can keep the game in the half court though, it's going to be to our advantage. That'll be Zach.
Nice job. Nice job by Zach Schroeder.
Love to see that.
9-7. Schroeder with the rebound. Just under 4 minutes to go, first quarter. That's a great move. That is a great move by Caleb Kaiser. Maybe the best move I've seen him have all year.
For sure. Took it off the dribble from the three-point line, over the top. And one.
And he gets the and one, gives the Redbirds a 10-9 lead. Out of bounds.
Yep. Should be off them.
They're going to call a jump ball. And you couldn't really tell who had
right,
it.
That's fair.
Yeah. Oh,
ooh.
Yep. Got him on the arm.
He did. Yep.
Redbirds top 32, Andy Kaiser, his first, team's first.
We'll go off the bench for the Redbirds.
Ooh, rolls out.
Solid start for Caleb Kaiser, though.
Yeah, that was...
good minutes.
Yes, real good minutes and a nice move to the basket. And gets the second, ties it up at 10, 3:20 to go. First quarter, tie it up.
Pressure. It'll get to you.
Yep.
Gotta keep that dribble alive.
Out of bounds, Metamora ball. Nice defense.
Yes, it was. They're really sitting back and making them make bad choices.
I think Metamora is the only team that brought their cheerleaders.
I think so, too. Great fans.
Good to see.
Oh, that's got to be a bucket, Ryan.
Oh, nice job by Gabe.
Good look from Ivins. A little long. Right there, Ryan should have gone up with it in the paint, right in front of the basket.
Yep. That'll get Klusky up off the Redbird bench.
Redbird's foul 33, right in the goal. His first, team second.
First one's up and misses. 2:15 to go. And he gets the second, 11-10, Lawndale.
Good catch. Ooh, had Schroeder on the cut. Anyway, that's his move to the left. Metamora, very patient.
Good.
Game possession.
14-11, Redbird. They only gave us two. Is that a two?
No, we had 10 before.
It's okay.
Oh, wait, rhymed the goal. Oh, that's a hustle play. I like that. I'm all right with that.
Yeah. Redbirds. That's two on Begol. That's just an unfortunate foul.
Yeah, it is. I think it's actually bothering those two guards out there.
I think it is.
Nice shot.
It ties it up at 13, 102 to go. Metamora might hold for one shot.
I can see it too, as long as they don't get pressured. At least too bad. It's a good look.
Good!
Just like that.
16-13 Redbirds. We're getting some nice looks. And they will hold for one shot.
30 left. And we'll let them, though. We don't want to get out there and guard them. Deep three. Offensive rebound. Ooh, air ball. Yep.
That got tipped. I believe that got tipped, didn't it?
I don't think it did. I think he's had a bad hold of the ball or something.
So the Redbirds will take a 16-13 lead into the second quarter. Joe, I think that was a really good quarter for Metamora.
Yeah, it was. We executed our shots, got in the paint, and we guarded pretty well. So it's a good first quarter. Good start.
Metamora's got to continue to be patient, take care of the ball, be strong with the ball. And when you get an open shot, you got
to
hit it.
Right. And, you know, that quarter they did a good job of, you know, not freaking out and hold on to the ball without turning it over. So they got to keep that up.
Andrew Guth checks into the Redbird lineup to start this second quarter. I think you're right, though. I think Zach Schroeder,
oh, yeah.
Really kind of disrupted their offense.
Right, and it may not be like really flashy, but this him being out there with his length is really disrupting.
Got a big steal and 2 points.
Yep. Another steal right on the sideline before Ryan's foul, but still, it's big.
So Metamora comes out with Mason, Klusky, Ivins, Guth, and Caleb Kaiser.
Yep.
Redbirds with a 16-13 lead.
Yeah, Looks like he come out and chin. Oh, Gabe was there. That's a good look.
Nice job. Nice job.
Ooh.
Good job by Metamora.
Rather strong.
Good.
I love it. Really scrappy.
Makes it 19-13 Redbirds, biggest lead of the game.
Yep. Gotta keep it. You know, and last year at this time, this is when Lawndale held the ball the entire quarter, so we'll see what they do this time.
They aren't going to be able to do it now because they don't have the lead.
Right, right, right.
Oh, nice Guth. Job by Guth.
Great hustle.
Nice job. Got his hand in there and got a dribble and knocked it away from the Lawndale player.
Yep. Sure did. Quick first step by Kaiser.
Oh, that's a great first step. He was going up for the dunk.
Yeah, he was. That would have been big. Plays like that, you know, get the whole bench involved.
Oh, yeah. Missed the first one.
How about Guth?
Oh, that's a great job by Andrew Guth.
Make a move, Caleb. Kind of scrambling right now. Three from Ivins. Ooh.
Oh, that's fouling Guth.
You got him.
Yep. Pretty good scrappy sequence down here, though, from Metamora.
Right. I love the hustle. We just got to get a bucket out of that.
His 19-13, Redbirds lead. 6:20 to go, second quarter.
The 1-3-1 they got this year is pretty effective on these teams that are quicker.
You got Ivins out top this time.
Yeah, with Schroeder on the bench.
Oh, that's just great defense.
Good board, Gabe. That a boy. Way to be strong.
Yeah, that a boy. That a boy, Gabe. That's just great defense, though, from Metamora.
Oh, for sure. Whole team collectively. Mason.
Good! 22-13 Redbirds. 5:40 to go, first half.
It's been a great start to the quarter. Deep three.
Oh, great box out.
Ooh.
Oh. That was a great box out by Metamora. Everybody had their guy on their hip.
It looks beautiful.
Oh.
Caleb had the block. I think that Nate got a, or Nate got the blocking foul call.
Yeah.
Yeah, Caleb had all that ball. They made the charge there.
First one's up and good. 22-14. Missed the second, stays 22-14, Redbirds lead.
Gotta believe there's five boards for Gabe now, at least.
Oh, yeah. Haven't been keeping track this game.
Right.
But, yeah, I think you're probably right.
Oh.
He was falling out of bounds. He did the right thing.
Yeah, he did. Deep three from
Oh, wow.
Really deep three.
22-17. Oh.
That's a good handle for the ball, though, by Fusky.
Yep. Ethan Kaiser will return to the Redbird lineup. And he'll replace Andrew Guth. Good minutes from Guth.
Oh, for sure, yeah.
Oh, man, they had Ethan Kaiser open to the basket.
They need the basket right here. Caleb and him are getting through down there. He's calling for it.
Good job. Good follow by Gabe.
Yeah, it was. Most of the ball.
24-17 Redbirds. Oh, he traveled.
Yeah, he did. It's good defense.
But Kaiser might have picked up the charge.
Oh, it wasn't one or the other. Charge or travel. That was a good look.
He's out of bounds. Ooh, they're calling Kaiser with the foul.
He's going to come down with that ball first, then go back up. He got, I think he thought too much, went too fast.
Zach Schroeder will come in. Looks like he will come in for Kaiser.
The third foul, he said? That can't be right.
Second. It's just his second.
Oh, okay. Yeah.
Both teams with five team fouls. 3:15 to go. First half, Redbirds up 24-17.
That's off left, yep.
Ivins with the rebound.
Good move.
And in, right down the lane for
coast
two.
To coast. That's a great move.
26-17. That's a great move by Ivins, and he was strong with the ball,
yeah,
too.
Yeah, he was. For the bigger guard, you need that. Good look for them. Yep. It's too open.
26-20.
Can't leave a shooter open. Ooh. How about Nate? That's smart. Get it back out. A lot of good looks from Metamora there.
A lot of good looks, yep. That's a pretty good move there. 26-22, Redbirds. Two minutes to go.
That was no easy shot that he just made right there, so. They got to get control of this possession right here. It's kind of getting out of hand for them.
Good.
He's on today.
Boy, ice water.
Yeah.
29-22 Redbirds. 1:25 to go, first half.
Big answer. They're getting some really quick shots up down there.
29-25.
Good move. This heavy strong, stay calm here.
All Under a minute to go.
Three from Ethan.
Good!
Man, they're hot this quarter. A lot of three balls.
32-25, 44 seconds to go, first half.
Should be us. Ooh, I don't agree with that call. I think I hit the kid in red first.
Bagol will return to the Redbird lineup in place of Klusky. Seconds. Redbird with a 7-point lead.
Yep.
Good job. Oh, that's a great way to end the half.
For sure. Big quarter for the Redbirds.
Redbirds will take a 7-point lead, 32-25 into the halftime locker room. What do you change if you're head coach Danny Greaves?
You know, all I would say is, you know, keep the pressure up on offense, you know, keep getting those clean shots off. But they're getting a couple of open looks down here from the 3-point line. I would just run them off a little bit more, and this should be fine.
Yeah, and I think that, you know, we missed a few three-point shots, but overall you had to be really happy with our shooting.
Right.
And the shots we took were all good shots.
Right, and even the ones that we've missed, we probably have at least 8 offensive rebounds too, so we should keep that up down here.
We'll be back in just a few minutes with the second half. Welcome back to the Shirk Center. Joe, you sometimes don't always want the first half to come to an end because we had some momentum. We were playing really well. I think that, you know, when you're playing that well, you don't want to have a break. But I think that was kind of a needed break for Metamora in the halftime when it came.
Right. Well, they played really well, but, you know, it's pretty fast-paced. So a good breather for all the guys would be nice. But it's going to be really tough, you know, this end of the third quarter, into the fourth, you know, keeping up the play style without getting too sped up.
Yeah, and, you know, I thought the first half, I thought the one thing that we did really, really well, other than we boxed out extremely well, we you know, they were going to get a few open looks. It's just the way basketball is.
Right.
But I thought we did an outstanding job of getting our shots, not panicking. We got a few more rebounds, offensive rebounds, than I thought we might be able to get.
Right.
I thought it was a very, very good first half. We have to continue that this half for sure.
Right. I think we controlled everything. You know, we shots we wanted, we took, had probably more assists, more rebounding, we're winning. So we got to keep up that style.
You know, they came out and they didn't even come out in time to shoot around. So.
Yeah. Probably go to the last unit in there.
So, actually, no, it'll be – I guess they gave that jump ball to Metamora to end the first half instead of just letting it run out.
Oh, wow.
And so it'll be North Lawndale ball to start this second half. Yeah, he did.
I saw that too. Oh man, same thing as first half.
Larry Johnson.
Need someone to help him out. Might get a 10-second call. There we go. Break it with the pass. There's a lob. Ooh, bad pass. It was there.
That climbs in. Metamora's going to have to take a quick timeout because that makes it 32-30, and they've gotten five quick points.
Right. Well, that's the guy for Lawndale, too, and Coach Greaves knows that, so he's probably pretty upset with that one.
We just have to settle. You knew they were going to make a run.
Right.
Settle down.
That'll be okay. Sure. Still up 2 points. We just got to get back to our style, which we had in the first half. There.
Yep. Good job by Gabe. Oh man.
I love it.
That was huge. Oh, that's a good no pass there.
That's 44. That's a great play.
Oh. Gotta catch it.
Could have been a board. Number three is their guy that really let him shoot the three ball for Lawndale. He's probably got at least three or four of them.
And that'll give them the lead, 33-32. They're on an 8-0 run right now.
Rough start with the third quarter with the Redbirds. They need a basket right here and then a stop. Good move by Schroeder. Ooh, I got fouled.
Good job by Kaiser.
They got a run. They got numbers, man. Gabe's really doing it all today, isn't he?
Yeah, he is.
Wide open. Attaboy, good fake.
Attaboy. Step through, gives us the lead back, 34-33.
You know he's a smart kid, you know. Learn from the last time. Step through with shot fake and everything. It's a great move. Ooh. Gotta stop the ball.
.535 to go in third quarter. Redbirds up by one, 34-33. This is the first. Brigol will come in for Caleb Kaiser.
That was his third foul, so.
Oh, yeah.
Ryan's also got two, so they'd be careful now. Still 5 minutes left in the third. Yep.
White ball, good job.
Too close, though.
Good foul.
Yeah, it was. Missed both of them. That's a foul. He pulled him out. Pulled a chair on him.
It's a nice entry pass.
Yeah, it was from was that Mason?
It was from Mason to Begol, yes.
Yep. Ooh.
Two shots.
I think he would have dunked that, but lost it on the way up.
So that'll send Kaiser to the line for two. Redbirds up by one, 34-33. 5:20 to go, third quarter. Just relax. Got to get the second.
Free throws. It's the story of the whole tournament, right?
It is. And he gets the second. 35-33.
Ooh, double teamed in the corner. That was a nice shot.
36-35, Lawndale. Still a pretty nice drive. Got to connect, though.
Yeah. Good finish. Wow.
You just can't let him go coast to coast. Right. You can't let him do that.
And this is the last thing that Coach Greaves wanted. It was a track meet. And this is what it's turning into.
Metamora will take a timeout. 38-35.
We're fine. We just got to slow the game down, you know, and get back to our style.
Redbirds trail by three, 38-35. A lot of basketball to be played yet.
Right, we'll be fine, I think. We just got to slow that game down a little bit. If they keep running, who knows? But
the Redbirds come out with Schroeder, Ivins, Mason, Begol, and Ethan Kaiser.
Someone's gonna come back and help him. There we go, Aaron. Very patient so far. D3 from Mason. Ooh. How about Ryan? That's an A1.
That a boy.
That was an A1.
Yep. Begol with a big rebound bucket.
And a nice block by Begol too. And the board.
There it is. Nice job by Begol. Nice job. 38-37, Lawndale. Redbirds trail by one. Nice lift so far from Begol.
Yeah, that was big. We need that. That changes the game. That's off.
Nice rebound by Schroeder.
They can help him out, though. Everybody can't just go out on the court. There we go. That's a good pass from Kaiser. Gets the rim, Gabe. Attaboy. Great.
There you go. And I give the Redbirds the lead back. 39-38. 3:10 to go. Third quarter.
Another board for Gabe. It's got to be 10 now.
Oh, at least.
Good pass from Mason to Kaiser.
Oh, that's beautiful. Yeah, that's beautiful. Kaiser screened his player off so well and gave him big target and just threw over the top. And
no help side there. It's perfect. Ooh.
How'd that get through?
Right through his arm and head, it looked like.
41-40 Redbirds, 2:14 to go, third quarter. Timeout Lawndale.
That was the timeout that Coach Greaves called about 2 minutes ago. It was a good one, though. You
oh,
know?
Yeah.
Good comeback for us.
You're right, though. I think the more Metamora makes them play defense,
right,
the more frustrated it seems like they get.
Right.
When they go up tempo, they seem to get into their rhythm.
When we have the control of the game, that's when they're taking the bad shots, and that's when they start missing. So we just like keep this up. It's like the first half.
Be Metamora's ball coming out of this timeout. Metamora comes back out with Ivins, Kaiser, Begol, Mason, and Schroeder.
Schroeder, though, staying calm.
Maybe it did go off Gabe's foot.
Yeah.
1:55 to go, third quarter. Klusky off the Redbird bench.
Looking for a three ball, I can tell. Oh, right past him. So that'd be some help side there.
Gives them the 1 point lead, 42-41.
That'd be strong, Gabe.
Atta boy. Nice job.
One more, perfect. That was a good look, though.
That was a real good, that's good ball movement.
We'll take that.
Under a minute.
That's a shot.
Atta boy, good job.
Did
it say off-white?
Though.
Say off-white, no.
It's gotta be a board. He had position on, too.
Klusky comes in for Schroeder. 52 seconds to go, third quarter. Redbirds trail by one.
I've seen this before.
Seconds.
We will take that. That's a terrible shot. Get up court. 2 seconds left.
Oh, yeah!
That's awesome.
Holy cow!
Great way to finish the quarter.
That was awesome.
It really was. Barely beat it. It was awesome.
Great outlet from Ethan Kaiser.
Yep.
And out in front to Begol, and we got the easy bucket. 43-42, Redbirds lead.
That was awesome.
So Metamora takes the 1 point lead into the fourth quarter, and they get the ball
right
to start the fourth quarter, and a little bit of momentum now with Metamora.
Right. You know, the quarter started off pretty rough. You know, they came out of the gate, 8-0 run for Lawndale, and we really finished out strong there, so I was glad to see that.
Yeah, it was they seemed to start the game and start the half awfully strong, but we weathered the storm pretty well in both cases.
Yep.
We've got to kind of finish the deal, though, now.
Yeah, for sure. This is where it gets hard, is crunch time. You know, it seems like this really fast. We just got to, you know, keep our legs.
So Redbirds come out the way they finished the third with Begol, Kaiser, Ethan Kaiser, Mason Klusky, and Landon Ivins. Redbirds clinging to the 1 point lead. Last 8 minutes of the tournament for the Redbirds.
Yep.
Good job by Begol to come get it.
He's had a great game, hasn't he? Off the bench. I needed yeah. that. A little energy. Good look from Ivins.
Oh, and he got it.
Great start.
46-42 Redbirds. Give us a little bit of breathing room. Don't. Oh, nice job by Gabe again.
Out of nowhere. Good pass from the goal. Oh.
Oh, man. He was too wide open.
Yeah. Great play, though. If it was three, he would have made it.
Begol with the rebound. Nice job.
How about Landon? Way to handle the ball. We'll take that, though.
Yep, yep. Boy, I bet Gabe wishes he had that back.
Oh, I know. That's how it's going to get all year. Ethan Kaiser's right there. Wow. He was wide open.
Oh, nice job. 48-42 Redbirds. Just under 7 minutes to go.
Pretty good defense there. Attaboy, Landon.
Good job, Landon. Good job. Way to be strong.
Yep. Hit on that ball. Wow.
Yep, and there's a foul.
Love to see it.
Boy, that's pretty gutsy for a freshman.
Oh, I know. How big he is, too.
Whew. Zach Schroeder up off the Redbird bench. He'll come in for Begol. What a contribution from Ryan Begol.
Great minutes. Big time minutes. He's making them count, that's for sure. Oh, yeah.
Good.
Wow. That was real deep. That was ballsy.
51-42 Redbirds. They'll tie their largest lead of the game so far.
Good board. Look at Zach. Ooh, good move.
Oh!
Coast to coast.
53-42.
Great start to the quarter. 11-point lead. Is it a 10-0 run for them?
Yes, it is. Yeah. Yes, it is. It was
43-42, right?
It was it was 41. We're on a 12-0 run.
We were down one?
We were down one, remember?
Oh, wow, wow. Could be a 14-0 run if you gave it that layup, could add back.
Yeah. .546 to go. We just got to be smart with the basketball from here on out, Joe.
Yep.
And we got to hit our free throws because there's going to be some free throws.
Right. You know, last night we were here, we were up seven against Wheaton Warren, or on Saturday, up seven against Wheaton Warrenville, and we just can't play not to lose. We have to play to win. So.
Yes. Oh, boy, you're exactly right.
It's a big difference.
A huge difference. And forgot to say the sponsors at the end of the third quarter. I'll go ahead and tell them now. Commerce Bank, Metamora McDonald's, Snyder Village, Goodfield State Bank, Ipavia State Bank, Zobershire Insurance, and the Germantown Grill. So it'll be Lawndale ball coming out of that timeout. Redbirds up 11. Metamora, it looks like they're going a little kind of a matchup zone here a little bit.
Right. I think they're protecting the paint, but still playing man-to-man. Could have been a push-off there.
Ooh. Oh, that climbed in. Makes it 53-44.
Here's the pressure.
Nice job. Nice job. Look opposite.
Gotta be with the pass.
Good job. Good job.
Just gotta stay calm. We'll be fine.
Oh, yeah. Nice job. Nice cut by Gabe.
Yeah, it was.
Nice feed. And wow.
He might have slowed a little bit there, but we'll take that.
He's 6'7", weighs 160 pounds.
Yeah.
He's not selling nothing.
Oh, yeah, you're right. Nice catch.
Cool. 53-47, Redbirds.
Leads back to six. Yep. That'd be strong. Ooh.
And he got it.
Man. That's what happens, though. You know, you blink and they're back.
Yep. 53-49. We got to be smart, though.
Yeah, we do. We're up three, but you know they have all the momentum right now. We got to get that back.
And it climbed in. It makes it 53-50. 4:30 to go.
There you go. We got a score right here. That's got to be a bucket. And one. That's all right. We'll take that.
Yep.
They got to keep driving off that, you know. They can't try to just get down there and hold the ball. We got to keep scoring.
4:24 to go. Two shots for Gabe Mason. Now they're on a 9-0 run.
Yeah.
That ended it. Good job by Gabe. 54-50.
We're gonna need all the points we can get, though. So every free throw from here, it's gotta be money.
Boy, that was almost a rebound from Kaiser.
Yeah.
But we need that rebound. We need that bucket.
We will take that.
Good job. Good defense.
Yes, it was.
4:02 to go. Redbirds up 4, 54-50.
That's a foul. Pretty strong, though.
Good job by Gabe. Good job.
Ball.
Redbird ball.
Too much on that one.
McGoal will come back into the Redbird lineup. He'll replace Klusky.
Good move. They're really doing a good job beating that press with the pass instead of the dribble.
Yeah, that's much, much better.
Good roll.
Good catch.
Yeah, it was.
By Mason.
Yeah. whole minute down the clock off this one possession right here. This is big.
Redbird's up four with 2:40 to go.
Oh, yeah. Broke his ankles.
Oh, yeah.
Broke his ankles. Oh, man. Great play.
56-50 Redbirds.
Over the back.
Over the back, sir. Yes.
Gabe Mason did it all today.
Man, that's bonus.
Yeah, it is.
That's bonus. 2:14 to go in the ball game, and the Redbirds are in the bonus here.
The next foul.
That was, we had six. That's, yeah, it's we're in the bonus now. Gabe's going to the line for a 1-1. That was great positioning by Gabe Mason.
Oh, yeah, it was. That's probably at least 25 and 15 for him tonight.
Oh, at least. He had 17 at halftime.
He's playing fantastic.
Gets the first. That's a big one. I think Lawndale's got one more run in them.
Oh, yeah. It's all about how we react to it. That'll be the end of the game.
.57-50, 2:14 to go in the ball game. Redbird's up by seven. And he gets them both.
That's big. Oh my gosh.
Oh. Traveled.
Yes,
travel.
Sir. Yep. Good call.
Timeout.
They're flustered.
Lawndale.
They're flustered.
58-50, 2:01 to go in the ball game. I'll tell you what, Joe, there's still a lot of time left.
Well, we've been here before, you know, on Saturday, and look what happened. So we just got to keep playing, keep scoring.
Let me ask you, you were in these situations.
Right.
Are the calmest people in this whole arena that have a dog in the fight, are they the five on the floor?
What's up?
Are the calmest, the ones that are least affected by this close game with, you know, coming down to the wire, or the five players on the floor?
Right. Well, when you're out there, honestly, in times like this, for me personally, I don't hear anything. It's just I'm so locked in. All I hear is my teammates and my coaches. But, yeah, this is exciting. All the I guarantee that the guys out there right now aren't tired right now. All the adrenaline they got.
And Gabe has played all 30 minutes so far.
I bet he's feeling a little bit. He's probably a little tired, but.
He can rest on the way home.
He can sleep when he's dead, you know. That's a foul. He's quick.
Nice.
He moves well for a freshman, wow. And one, no call. Wow.
That's gonna be a foul on Bagul. .135 to go. That'll send. First one's up and good, 58-51. And he gets them both, makes it 58-52. 1:35 to go in the ball game. Redbirds up six. That's just two possessions.
Good move. Yes.
Yeah.
I think that call down there at the bench with Lawndale. Wow.
For Lawndale, now number three, Damian Rogers.
And they have the possession arrow, so.
Yeah.
And that'll send Ethan Kaiser to the line for a one and bonus.
It feels like they've had the arrow the whole game, though, for jump balls.
First one's up and good. 59-52. And he gets them both.
Sweet story. Wow.
60-52 with 1:26 to go in the ball game.
Good luck.
Oh, man. 60-55.
They'll sit back. That's good. Good choice. Don't dribble.
Metamora calls a timeout. Holy cow!
Wow. That's fortunate. That was a basket. They're saying we're cheating. That's classic.
1:02 to go. Redbirds will have the ball coming out of the timeout. That's a big timeout by Coach Greaves.
Yeah, it was.
Here, Colnoy says, you hear the whistle and they call the timeout, but you got to go back about 2 seconds because you got to give the referee time to blow the whistle
right.
after he hears timeout.
They got to register it all, but people don't realize that.
But, you know, if we're on the other side, we'd be complaining.
Oh, yeah, for sure. That's just how it is. That's basketball.
60-55 with 1:02 to go. Redbirds up by five. Got to take care of the basket, and you got to hit your free throws.
Right. That's been the story of the season. It's been good, bad, a little bit of both, but tonight's got to be free throws. Great catch, perfect goal. Was there a receiver coming down on that one?
Yeah, yep, there's the.
Phoenix foul, zero, Jamar Wilkins is second.
And that'll send Ryan Begore to the line for one and bonus. We're in the double bonus from here on out with exactly 1 minute to go. Got to hit both of these.
We still got three fouls to give, too, so that'll be big.
The bonus.
Good.
Nice shot.
Boy, that's a big shot there, too.
That's cold as ice.
And he gets them both.
That's big.
Whoa, man.
That's a pretty clean look, yeah.
Wow. 62-58 with 54 seconds.
Man. I feel like every team shoots pretty well against us from three-point line every game.
Why do teams have so much success against us?
I don't understand. Every year.
I mean, you know, every one of our buzzer beaters have been, with the exception of Morton last Friday night.
Threes?
They're all threes.
Yeah. Still a lot of ball game left that we played.
Thank you.
Good pass.
Seconds to go. That'll send Landon Ivins to the line. That's a, is that double bonus
yeah,
now?
Yeah, it'll be two. We were at 9 before, or they were at least.
Landon Ivins, two shots.
Up and good. Whew. 63-58. And he gets them both. That was huge. 64-58.
Pick up ball.
Oh, yeah. Push off. They pushed off Gabe.
Wow.
That'll send, I think, Gabe to the line for two more shots.
I didn't see that call, but it was
yeah.
The foul, but that's fortunate.
Seconds to go. Redbirds up 64-58. Gabe Mason goes to the line with for two shots. Oh, it climbs out.
That's all right, though. I'd rather make the second one right here. Slow the game down a little bit.
Good.
Yep.
65-58, 7-point lead. That's three possessions.
Attaboy, Gabe Mason.
And that'll...
Quick jumps this game, really quick whistles.
26 seconds to go. It'll be Lawndale ball under their own basket. Holy cow.
Wow.
Jesus, he had a hand in his face.
He had a setback. That was not an easy shot.
'65-61, Redbirds, 21 seconds to go.
Why can't we make shots like that?
That was just a heck of a shot.
Can't guard that. We were guarding it, but wow. Great catch by Mason there.
Phoenix number one, Daquan Davis, his third.
19 seconds to go. Gabe Mason will go to the line. We're getting the right guy to go to the line.
Yeah, we are.
Gets the first, 66-61. 19 seconds. Oh, and he missed the second one. Are they going to put more time on the clock?
I guess. The ball should be able to bounce, but.
Clock will be reset to 10 seconds. 10 seconds.
Redbirds up two, 66-64.
All I gotta do is catch here and make two free throws.
Metamora will take a timeout.
Timeout, Metamora. Full timeout.
This turned into a long quarter, hasn't it?
Ooh, man, the last couple minutes have been long.
Yeah.
Because they've been taking timeouts after every basket.
Right. How many are left, you know?
I think they're out.
We have one left.
We have one left. They have none. Oh, it's up there, too. Well, that was a long 3 seconds, wasn't it?
Yeah, it was. We'll take that, though. All the time we can get off the clock, we'll take.
He's got to hit both of these.
He's got to be getting tired, too. These are really big for him.
Phoenix is on number 11. Javonte Rackett is fourth. At the line for the Redbirds, Dave Mason. Two shots.
Two shots for Gabe.
No legs on that one.
And he gets to say, that's a big one.
We'll take
that's
that.
A big one.
No threes here, guys.
Oh, and it goes out of bounds!
Wow. Wow. He just slipped. About time something came our way. No way.
No, oh, yeah.
No, it's not again.
Oh. Oh.
Thank God.
Wow. Boy. That's a heck of a ball game,
Joe.
Down to
the wire. Wow.
That was a
back-to-back great ones.
67-64. Redbirds escape with a win.
Yep.
Wow, that's a heck of a win. Third place finish.
What did we get last year?
We got the Constellation second place.
Okay.
I don't know if there was a trophy involved, though. So, yeah, man, that's...
wow. That was a big win for us.
That pushed the Redbirds' record to 9-3.
Yep.
Now we have the head coach Danny Greaves, the captains of the Metamora Redbirds step forward for their third place trophy in the 2019 State Fair Holiday Classic Art School Bracket.
That's a nice finish for Metamora.
Yeah, it is. Yeah, it is.
3-1, and this is a pretty solid tournament.
Yeah, it was. Lost a close one to Wheaton. You know, we'll take that. I'd say it was a good weekend all around.
Yeah, it pushes, like I said, it pushes our record to 9-3 overall.
Yep.
And sets us up pretty well for this second half next Saturday night at Metamora, second home game of the year against a pretty good Manual team.
Yeah, they're pretty solid. I remember last year, and I think it might be even better this year than last year, so we'll see.
Ladies and gentlemen, your attention, please.
We'll be back in just a few minutes and a chat with head coach Danny Greaves. Well, coach got a little excited and left without the interview, so that'll do it from the Shirk Center. Redbirds win. We'll see you Saturday night at home against Manual.